Yair Rosenberg, tell us about these impersonator trolls that you were trying to target. What exactly are they?
So you've heard about probably fake news. So these are fake Jews and also fake Muslims and fake African Americans, all sorts of minorities on Twitter where basically a racist troll goes online, appropriates the image of a minority, someone who looks demonstrably, say, religious, like a religious Muslim woman or a religious, you know, Jewish man, and puts that costume on, so to speak, and then inserts themselves into conversations on social media, saying offensive, racist, and otherwise off-putting things so that the unsuspecting person scrolling through their social media feed sees someone who looks like a minority being incredibly offensive and outlandish.
You were personally a target of racists and anti-Semites a lot during the 2016 election campaign. Were you particularly targeted as well by these imposter trolls?
I got a lot of this sort of abuse, like many other Jewish journalists, while covering the 2016 election campaign. You know, like some of them, I did get, you know, some of these impersonator people. Certainly, once I started writing about the phenomenon and I created this bot, that inspired certain people to create imposter accounts of me. But also, precisely because I'm a bit high profile on the issue, it was relatively easy to get them suspended. It's a lot harder to get sort of the random imposter trolls that are just using random images of Jews or others off the platform, because those are much harder for people to notice because they're not necessarily going after someone as big a fish as me.
Why did you decide that you needed to go after these trolls with a bot?
I'm a big believer in finding ways to solve problems on social media that are sort of bottom up. I think users should like fight back against people who misuse the platforms, because most users want platforms to be, you know, healthy and honest. The idea with the bot was, we don't need to censor these accounts. They don't need to necessarily be shut down. I mean, if Twitter wants to, that would be wonderful, but that's their choice. But what we can do is we can alert any users that these trolls are trying to deceive and say, you think this person who's interacting with you is really a Jew or really a Muslim, but they're not, right? And maybe here's a screenshot showing where they stole their picture from or something like that. And so we created this bot that automatically interjected into any conversation where the troll tried to insinuate themselves and expose them.
Yeah, how do you get it to insinuate itself? How does that actually work? Did you work with somebody to come up with a way to develop this thing?
Exactly. So the way the story goes is that I knew these particular trolls were out there because I'd often encounter them because I got all this abuse during the election campaign, and I saw this particular variety of troll, and I tweeted to my own followers and said, would it be possible to create a bot that would respond to a database of these sorts of accounts that we put together? And a developer in San Francisco named Neil Chandra, who I've never met and still haven't, but we're now friends, said, sure, I can do that overnight. And I was like, well, that's pretty cool. And then we tested it for a week, and then we unleashed it on the internet.
And as you pointed out, it's been pretty effective in annoying these people to the point that Twitter has shut the bot down twice. Why?
Basically, what happened was is that these imposter trolls realized that they couldn't beat the bot. The bot, no matter what they did, some of them tried to change their usernames, but we had thought those through, and we made sure that you couldn't do that. And so it was spoiling all their fun. Some of them just started reporting the bot to Twitter and said, this bot is harassing me, right? Which looks like abuse if you take it out of context, right? But if you know that these people are abusive users, and this bot is simply exposing the abusive users to people who are then saying thank you, right? You would see it in a totally different light. But they took advantage of the fact that Twitter doesn't really understand all this sort of stuff that's going on in their platform or isn't interested enough in figuring it out, and basically manipulated their own rules to get the bot taken down.
After the first time Twitter shut down the bot, you were able to get it restored again. Now, of course, it's been shut down permanently. In a statement to Mashable, Twitter said, everyone on Twitter must follow the Twitter rules, including our rules that prohibit hateful conduct, as well as the rules that prohibit spammy behavior and automated mentions of other people. Do you think they had a point in shutting down what you were doing?
So, as I said, if you look at it and you abstract it from the moral context and you don't say what are the users that the bot is responding to doing versus what is the bot doing, you can say the bot is harassing these random users. But once you realize those people are actually harassing and abusing other people, right, impersonating minorities and then using that to spread hate on the platform, well, then at minimum you have that's the tier one problem. And the tier two problem is you think the bot is not the best way to go after it. So then you should solve the tier one problem and then say, well, we don't need the bot. But instead, they got rid of the bot. All those people that our bot was calling out and labeling and so on, now they're running free, and no one is exposing them, and no one is alerting the users they're trolling right, that they're being misled and deceived by impersonator trolls.
So do you just assume that they've taken on another identity and are doing it all over again?
In theory, they can, you know, change their guise as many times as they want, but we will eventually find out about it again because we're based on user reports.
But what are you going to do about it now that you're not allowed to use the bot?
This is a great question. Now, it becomes entirely Twitter's problem because they took away the one solution that existed on the platform itself. All that people have right now as a recourse is they can report it to Twitter and hope somebody at Twitter's desk is smart enough to figure out what they're looking at. But I don't have high confidence because in the New York Times article itself, we gave two examples of these, just two. And I have a database of dozens and dozens. But two examples of these imposter trolls. One of them, because of the bot, changed his avatar and everything and went back to being a normal racist account and no longer is dressed up as a rabbi. So that was a success story. The other one was a more recent one, and we had only just put the bot on it before he was suspended, so it's still there on the platform doing the exact same things. And even though we were in the New York Times, showed this guy, right, saying, hey, horrific abusive things, so those should be suspended regardless, right, Twitter hasn't done anything about it. I don't see them taking the steps, because that's like the lowest of low-hanging fruit, right, is just to suspend the guy we identified in the New York Times article and showed saying racist things, but they didn't do that.
Mr. Rosenberg, thank you very much for explaining this all to us.
Well, thank you for having me.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.